In today's video, I am going to explain basic movement of shoulder joints and their main muscles. I am going to explain 8 movements. That sounds a lot, but they are so important movements. From first picture, I am going to explain abduction and adduction. Abduction is this way. This is abduction. Abduction. The other way, this way is adduction. Abduction and adduction. Let me list 3 muscles for abduction. First one is deltoid. Deltoid. That's very big muscles. It's like this. Okay, this is deltoid. When deltoid pulls humerus this way, now that can do abduction. Simple, right? Next one is deep to deltoid. That's supraspinatus. Supraspinatus is deep to deltoid. It's like this. This is deep muscle. Same thing like deltoid. When supraspinatus pulls humerus this way, now it's abduction. This is simple. Next one is little bit tricky. That's biceps brachii. Biceps originates from scapula and it goes like this. Biceps is elbow muscle. Same time that can move shoulder, that can do abduction. Okay, that's very important. Biceps brachii. Deltoid, supraspinatus, and biceps brachii. Now for adduction, let me explain 3 muscles as well. First one is big chest muscle. That's pectoralis major, pec major. Pec major. Then let me explain next one. Next one is on posterior surface. That is latissimus dorsi. Latissimus dorsi. They originate from chest and back. Let's pretend this blue area is both for pec major and latissimus dorsi. When these 2 guys pull humerus this way, now that is adduction, right? Pec major is on front part. Latissimus dorsi is on back part. They can do adduction. Last one is teres major. Teres major is also on back part, so it's like latissimus dorsi. When teres major contracts, that can do adduction. Okay, this is abduction and adduction. Let's go to next 2 movements. Next movements are rotational movement, internal rotation and external rotation. Internal rotation and external rotation. Let me explain 3 muscles for internal rotation. Pec major, deltoid anterior fiber, deltoid anterior fiber, and teres major. Of course, other muscles can do internal rotation, but 3 muscles are kind of adequate numbers, right? Pec major, deltoid anterior fiber, and teres major. Pec major, deltoid, and teres major. It's simple to visualize pec major and deltoid anterior fiber, right? They are on anterior part. When they contract this way, of course, they can do internal rotation. But how about teres major? That's from kind of posterior part. Scapula is on posterior part. Teres major attaches to scapula, so it's from posterior part. However, it attaches to anterior part of humerus. this kind of spiral orientation makes internal rotation. Yep, teres major is important for internal rotation. How about external rotation? Also, three muscles. First one is deltoid posterior fiber. Deltoid posterior fiber and infraspinatus. Then teres minor. They are all on backside of shoulder. Do you remember? Pec major and deltoid anterior fiber are on anterior part. No doubt they can do internal rotation. How about deltoid posterior, infraspinatus, and teres minor? They are all on posterior part. No doubt they can do external rotation. Let's go to next two movements. Next two movements are this and this. Going up is flexion. Going down is extension. Same thing. Three muscles for flexion. First one is pec major. Pec major. Next one, deltoid anterior. Deltoid anterior fiber. And biceps, brachii. They are all anterior part. So I see this is deltoid and pec major is here. And biceps brachii is here. They are all on anterior part. Imagine when biceps contracts this way, flexion happens. Same thing for pec major and deltoid anterior fiber. They all bring shoulder to shoulder flexion. Okay, biceps is so important for shoulder movement, not only for elbow movement. Pec major, deltoid anterior fiber, and biceps. They are all on front part. Now, extension can be opposite. They all should be on back side. So, such as latissimus dorsi. Latissimus dorsi. Deltoid posterior fiber. And teres major. They are all on posterior part. So they run like this. Imagine this pink color is all shoulder extensor. When they contract this way, now you can do extension. Flexion muscles are on anterior part. Extension muscles are on back part. Now let's go to last two movements. This is superior view of human body. Next two movements. This movement and this movement. This movement is kind of like dumbbell fly. This is horizontal adduction. Horizontal adduction. This way is horizontal abduction. Okay, let me list two muscles for each movement. So, what is main muscle for dumbbell fly? That is pec major, of course. Pec major and deltoid anterior fiber. Deltoid anterior fiber. Imagine they are all on anterior part. Imagine this is pec major. This is deltoid anterior fiber. When they contract this way, of course, horizontal adduction happens. Horizontal abduction is completely opposite, such as deltoid posterior fiber. And latissimus dorsi. Imagine deltoid posterior fiber and latissimus dorsi. When they contract this way, that brings shoulder to horizontal abduction. I explained 8 basic movements of shoulder joint. Shoulder is very flexible joint and it's very movable joint. Thus, understanding each movement and each muscle is so important to analyze anatomy, function, kinesiology, biomechanics, and so many things. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.